Hello all, I am Sharvali Sarnaik and today we will be seeing 3D scaling. So as we know, scaling means enlarging or reducing the size of the object, or you can say increasing or decreasing the size of the object. So we have already seen in the 2D scaling that we have the scaling factors Sx and Sy. So how we plot the coordinates in the matrix form, that is Sx and Sy. So this is the 2D scaling matrix. Okay, so in this, see here, only the diagonal points we take. So if we are taking the 3D, then my points for the scaling will be Sx, Sy and Sz. So these three points I have for the 3D scaling. Now let's see how to plot that. As we know, we have the formula that original points into t. So that means original point we will be having x, y, z and 1. This 1 is my homogeneous coordinate. Now I want to plot the matrix for the scaling. So when I want to plot the matrix for the scaling, we know the diagonal points will be 0. So in this case, how we will be considering it as the diagonal will be A, then 0, 0, 0. Means A, B, C, D. These points A only will be there because we are taking the diagonal point. Then we have 0, E, 0, 0. Then 0, 0, J, 0. So my last coordinate will be 0, 0, 1. That this one is the homogeneous factor. We have not considered H because H will be standing for homogeneous factor. So directly we have taken the J. So see, my diagonal points will be there and rest all it will be 0. So we have considered the diagonal points as this is my this fourth matrix, 4x4 matrix will be considered into the homogeneous coordinates. Now see A, B, Z, C. Now B and C will be 0 because we will be considering only the diagonal points. So A, 0, 0, that means A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. H we have not considering because H is standing for homogeneous. So we will be taking the next part, I and J. So here, this year we having J. So see, for better understanding, my matrix will be, suppose this is my Sx, then 0, 0, then Sy, then Sz, and this is my homogeneous factor 1. So this is how my matrix 3D scaling will be. Okay, so this is the 3D scaling transformation matrix. Okay. Just we have taken the AEG in the ABCD form. So this will be my in the 3D scaling. So just calculate this matrix with it. This matrix we will get AX into CY, sorry EY into JZ and 1. So this will be by new points, that is X star, Y star and Z star and 1. So this is how the 3D scaling is. Now let's take one example of 3D scaling. So see, this is the example of 3D scaling where we have to consider a rectangular parallel pipe, I call it as an RPP, with an homogeneous position vector. This vector is already given, that means this is my original point. Okay, this is the original point vector, and scaling factor is also given, that is 1/2, 1/3, 1 along XYZ axis. That means we have this Sx, this is my Sy and this is my Sz. So we have to calculate the we have to just write the matrix for T. So my transformation matrix will be, as we know, with the transformation matrix we have is, see here, we have already seen, this is my transformation matrix Sx, Sy, Z, X, Sz. In the diagonal way we write it. So here my points will be Sx is 1/2, so it is 1/2. Then Sy is 1/3 and Sz is 1. So this is my T. Okay, so this is my T. Now I want to find the new point, that is I want to find the X star. So as we know, my X star will be X into T. I want to find the X star. So my X star will be X into T. That means we will be multiplying these two. So this is my X and this is my T. So we will be multiplying this X into T. Now after multiplying this X and T, I will be getting, so after multiplying x into t, I got this matrix. So you see here, suppose this is my original point, okay? So this is my original rectangular parallel piped, okay? So these points are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. This all already given. So this is our matrix for this original point, okay? So when I translate this, or when I rotate this, I get the answer this, okay? So after scaling the original object, so this is my original object, and after scaling this, I got this, okay? I got this. That is my A star. So I got this as my object after scaling. So see, this is my original object. After scaling, this is my new object. So this is the local scaling. Okay, so this is the local scaling where we scale the object. That is, this is my original object and this is my new object. Okay, this is called as local scaling. Now we will see overall scaling. For overall scaling, let's see overall scaling. Now for overall scaling, consider this same, okay, this is my A, that is my original point. I will call it as A. This is my original point, okay. Now I want to scale it by factor 2. That means my scaling factor I have is 2, because we have to double the size. So we have to double the size, that means my t will be, now in this case my t will be 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 by 2, because my I want to double the size, okay. So when I multiply this x star to find the x star, my formula will be x into t. So this is my x and this is my t. When I double it, okay, or sorry, I multiply it, x into t, I will be getting the x star, okay. So this will be my object. So this is my original, this is my original, this is A. Suppose this is my A. Now when I take the scaling factor 2, this will be my object, okay. That means the size of the object is doubled. So this is my object, having scaling factor 2. Thank you.